Good evening, everyone. This is Trolling Azeroth, or Ash, if you would prefer. Wanted to take a few minutes of your time and discuss some of the highlights coming out of BlizzCon 2018 this year, especially pertaining to the World of Warcraft. There were two really cool cinematics, and a lot of news as to what's to come for the game over the rest of this expansion. The first of the cinematics is actually a hype piece just for the second Warfront we're going to see, called Terror of Darkshore. Now, couple of really big things, or cool things, that come out of this cinematic. One, Malfurion Stormrage has fully recuperated, and he seems to be pretty pissed. He decimated a horde, a scouting party, carrying supplies to the warfront, and managed to scare the piss out of one troll just long enough for him to run back and tell Nathanos as to actually what happened. This has been a sight for sore eyes, and has been badly needed for a very long time. Malfurion was one of my favorite characters in Warcraft 3. I fell in love with him almost immediately, so we were very, very disappointed. Me and I would like to thank millions of others of Alliance fans and Malfurion fans when he was actually introduced into World of Warcraft, not the character we knew and loved in Warcraft 3. So it's great to see him back and actually demonstrating why he's one of the more powerful beings on Azeroth. Second thing out of the cinematic was actually another Warcraft 3 homage. It's the demonstration of a old Priestess of the Moon ability called Scout. That ghostly white owl that you see flying around throughout the cinematic and eventually landing on Tyrande's arm at the very end, that was simply called Scout. And it did exactly what the name implies. A Priestess of the Moon would send the Scout out, and you could scout out enemy fortifications and their camps to determine which was the best way to attack them. So to actually see them put that in a cinematic was pretty cool. Second cinematic was one of the more high quality, more akin to the expansion cinematic intros that we've seen in the past. It's called Lost Honor. It highlights Anduin going to see Sourfang while he's still imprisoned in the Stormwind Stockades. First of all, again, The graphics are mind-blowing. I really wish Blizzard would just take the time to do their own movie. They've got the time, they've got the talent, they've got the money. There's really nothing stopping them for just actually biting the bullet and getting it done. I think millions of fans would love to see them do it themselves instead of partner with or rely on another studio to do it. Not a lot of shocking stuff here as it relates to lore. Funnily, we do see Anduin managed to find himself in a prison with another orc that could rip him in half if he wanted to. Remember, back when Garrosh was on trial, Anduin would visit him often to, I guess, appeal to his conscience if Garrosh actually had one. So it's good to see him visit another orc. Thankfully, this one was a little kinder and didn't want to rip his face off entirely. The one truth we did learn is that Anduin allowed Sourfang to escape Stormwind. That was the big lore reveal at the end of this. For a time, we had heard rumors that maybe it was Matthias Shaw. That turned out to be not the case. Anduin let Sourfang go so Sourfang could help him defeat Sylvanas, which Anduin readily admits that he can't do by himself. This is super important because this leads to the much-discussed choice questline that Horde players will get to participate in 8.1. If you haven't heard already, spoiler alert, the player will get to decide if you will help Sourfang and Zakan, or if you'll pledge your allegiance to Sylvanas, and there will be repercussions for your decision. This is a first for World of Warcraft. A major choice like this for a story quest has never existed before. I believe that this is their first move toward a major shakeup of the game's faction system. As for what's to come, when Battle for Azeroth was being teased, we were led to believe that Ashara was going to be the major boss for the first tier of raiding, much like Gul'dan was in Legion. Obviously, that is not the case here. 8.1's penultimate raid is going to be the Battle of D'Zora Lor, which again will be another first for World of Warcraft, where we'll see the factions be each other's raid bosses. It looks as though we won't see Ashara until the end of 8.2, when we assault Na'jatar itself and the Queen's Eternal Throne. This is where I believe things are going to get very, very interesting. I don't think we're going to kill Ashara in this raid. I think she's going to be betrayed and pushed into retreat. I don't think she's going to be betrayed by some lackey either. I think she's going to be undermined by N'Zoth himself. I think he's going to finally put her in her place and make her understand that whatever thoughts she had of equality with him were premature. Besides, he has his eyes on her replacement. Someone not as powerful as Ashara, but just as manipulative and deceitful. Someone who is emotionless and cold and brutal. One Sylvanas Windrunner. Blizzard has stated multiple times that Sylvanas is not going to be Garrosh 2.0. I believe them. She's not going to be a raid boss anytime soon. She's not going to die in this expansion either. I believe that she's going to become the leader of a new faction that services Death. She said it herself when Vol'jin died. In the end, Death claims us all. We won't realize this betrayal just yet, especially who orchestrated it, but it will give us a tantalizing whodunit mystery taking us into 8.3. And speaking of 8.3, I believe that the last raid in that patch is going to be in Nyalotha, or the Shadowlands, where we will be so bold as to confront N'Zoth himself. This will give Blizzard the opportunity to do something else they've never done before, allow us to lose. Don't get me wrong, we'll get new loot, but the overall narrative is going to be watching Ashara finally die at the hands of N'Zoth, or tentacles, Sylvanas get elevated to take her place, and N'Zoth soundly kicking our collective asses and ending our threat to his domain. If it goes down like this, it'll open another new door for Blizzard, shaking up the factions. With Sylvanas gone, it'll fall to Nathanos to lead the Forsaken, if he's still alive. I do believe that Sourfang and Ginn will both be dead by the end of the expansion. That will leave Anduin and Jaina left to take care of the Alliance. But Thrall will be needed to come back and lead what's left of the Horde. Yeah, that's right. I believe Thrall is going to come back and assume the mantle of War Chief once again. So Blizzard could use this as an opportunity to allow any race to choose whatever faction they wanted, still pitting the Horde and Alliance against each other and whatever new threats emerge. Or they could use Sylvanas' new Death Group to be a third playable faction and really mix things up. I honestly don't know which I'd prefer. My gut tells me they're eventually going to allow the faction wall to be smeared. Humans and gnomes can join Thrall, and trolls and Tauren can fight for Anduin. But I don't know if they're willing to pull the trigger and allow Sylvanas to helm a third faction. That would split the Horde player base and have more of an impact on their player numbers than it would the Alliance. So what do you guys think? Am I crazy? Do you want Sylvanas to pull the rug out from under Ashara? Will we ever see a third playable faction? Please let me know in the comments below, and please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for listening, and everyone have a great night. Will you take part?